Hi, everyone.
I hope you guys start signing on. I hope that I have good internet access. Can you guys hear me or am I freezing? I really hope I'm not freezing. I should have good internet access. If you don't hear me well or I'm freezing, please let me know. I am working on getting a hardwire internet connectivity. Because I don't think my service is as good on Facebook as it's been on live. So please let me know if my connectivity isn't good. Hi, everyone. Hi. Hi, everyone. It sounds good. Okay, good. So if my connectivity isn't good, just alert me. And I already ordered. I'm going to hardwire my internet. Hi, everyone. Okay, I love you. I'm so happy everyone's coming in now, and I'm so happy you're all in the group. I know it took time, but you're here, so welcome. We have like 26,000 bunnies in this group right now, which is amazing and so exciting, and it's so important for just creating and fostering a really positive network that we can all learn from each other and love. So actually, I didn't mention this, but one thing I want to cover today is how to run a group dynamic and how to make sure that's great. So I'll start with that group dynamic. Okay, so let's start by talking about the group dynamic. Everyone, I want you to continue to post your aha moments, your successes, how much weight you're losing, how good you're feeling, how great your success groups are doing, and everything else. Please, 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 everyone, do not, whatever you do, please promise me, do not ever get jealous. I hate that J word. I think jealousy is one of the worst traits anyone could have, okay? When someone within our group does well and is successful, it's a feather in all of our caps. If one person is successful, that means all of our chances are higher for being successful as well. So if you lost 1 pound at this point and someone else posted they lost 11, it's all good. You're always learning and you're always improving, and the best is yet to come, and you're always getting better with time. And the 2B mindset, what we've seen with the test groups, what I've seen with my clients, is you can actually, and what we've seen is that people tend to lose more weight in month 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 than they do in month 1. So it's only been a week. If you've lost a lot of weight, amazing, then you're going to continue. If you didn't lose as much weight, you're learning from it, and you can lose way more next week and the weeks after. And if someone's success group is doing better, and then ask them. Tony Robbins has a great line: successful people leave crumbs. If one person's doing really well and losing a lot of weight, follow them on social media, see what meals they're eating, ask them a private question like, oh wow, it seems like you're doing really well at this. Like, any tips that Ilana hasn't covered that you can give me some insight for? That is what this group is about. Remember, people, positive weight loss. You have to stay positive. And it's never too late to get it together. If one day you overate, or one day you felt like you gained weight, or that you didn't make the best choices, dust it off and get right back up. Every day is a new start, is a fresh start, is a day to be amazing. On the 2B mindset, you never wait till Monday. You never wait till June 1st. You get it together. If one day you didn't drink as much water, you forget your water bottle at home, you made any slip up, you dust it off, you track it all down, you learn from it, and you start fresh and new. We always have a new opportunity to be amazing, and it's called tomorrow or later today. So there's no cheating with the 2B mindset. As long as you track it, you're on track. Okay? So if you overeat, if you overdo, if you forgot this, if you forgot that, it's all good. There is no perfect, and every day is a learning experience, especially in the first month. So please stay positive, stay supportive, be encouraging of each other. When you see someone else in the group say that they had so much success with their weight loss, with overcoming emotional eating, please give them a like and a heart, because we all need one another to uplift one another, and this is supposed to be like this safe, pleasant haven that we use to escape all the negativity out there. So let's just keep bringing each other up and infusing more positivity and encouragement into the group, staying focused on our own journeys and our own successes, and being open-minded to learning from others in a positive way, not in a negative way, okay? So, all right. Yes, Jan, comparison is the thief of joy. We're all on our own journeys and our own paths. Okay, so I wanna cover that. The next thing I wanna cover today is, and if you guys see, I posted, and every time I do a live, I'll post like kind of what I wanna cover that day. So I also wanna cover what was covered in previous live videos. A lot of you are gonna ask me now to answer questions that were probably answered in previous live videos. I'm trying to wear a different color shirt in every live video so I can reference them. But if you go to the announcements at the top of the page, I already did two live videos in the group. The first live video, I'm wearing a black top, and I spoke about exercise and modifications. I spoke about how to track best. If you're new to the group and you haven't watched that yet, the best way to remember how to track, the best thing you can do right now, and I'm going to repeat this, everyone take out your cell phones. Take out your phones and go to the clock. Okay, so whatever phone you have, even if you don't have a smartphone, even like the oldest, most basic phones have an alarm on it. Okay, so it doesn't have to be fancy at all, but make sure you take out the alarm. I want you to set 3 alarms a day, and it should be like a little chime. It doesn't have to be an obnoxious ring. A little chime that says 10 a.m., remember to track, 3 p.m., remember to track, 8 p.m., dinner and done. Great job, bunny. Have a great night. Get some sleep. Track everything, and you're good to go. So I really recommend everyone set reminders on your phone. Make sure your challengers and your customers are setting reminders on your phone. It should have happy face emojis. It should be a pleasant ringtone, because even if you're in the middle of driving or doing something or running an errand, if you just see that reminder and you press it, I should just stay on track and track. The more you track, the better you'll do. Never get too cocky and think you're above the tracker. We always need to track, whether you need to lose 100 pounds or you need to lose 2 pounds, or you don't even need to lose weight at all. You're just working on your relationship with food and figuring out your best system. The more you track, the better. You cannot over track. If you bite it, you write it, and you are going to have the best experience through it. Okay. So the only thing I have to always say is refer to the tracker, and the best answers for you guys as coaches and for me to explain to you, if you have any questions ever, should I eat this? When should I eat this? What if I'm a night shift worker? What if I'm craving this? How do I eat this? How do I track this? Is one slice of bread good for me, or is 2 slices of bread good for me? Any questions you or anyone ever has with the 2B mindset, it usually comes down to one answer, which is track it and see. Track it and see. I can't answer every question for you. You can't answer every customer's question for you. We're all different. If you find a food product, you don't know if it's a protein or a carb. Track it and see. If you are on your period and you're craving chocolate and you want to know if you can have it or not, just track it and see. We're all different. There's no perfect. It's all about trial and error and figuring out your best system. So the best thing you can do is always track it and see. If you're working out and you want to know if you need a post-workout snack, whatever it is, just track it and see. And that is really like the fundamental answer to everything. So make sure that you are tracking and you set those reminders. Other things that we covered on previous live calls is exercise and modifications. Read through the Q&As. The Q&As have such good answers in them. A lot of you are asking how much to eat. The answer to how much to eat is always track it and see. More sure model, because the more sure model is really kind of the answer to like how much protein do I need? How many carbs do I need? Just the more sure model, track it and see. Trust yourself. Because like I said, you're always either losing weight or learning from it. So you always have to have that open, positive mind. So that's everything I covered in the first live video in the announcements in a black top. Then I did another live video in a green top and I covered how to use the scale on a daily basis. Week to week, you should be looking at your progress. Daily is just information. Never get so discouraged if you see it go up. Learn from it. Refer to the tracker. And if you don't have a lot of details in the tracker, that's the information you need, that you need to be putting more information in order to see more success. So the scale is your friend. You're either learning or you're losing, and it's all good. And it's all just day to day. You're not going to see 3 pound loss in a day. 2 ounces in a day is a win. So always just think, can I lose 2 ounces? Everyone can lose 2 ounces. I could do that. Just be positive and always know you can always lose weight as fast as you can gain weight. You need to know that. You need to start seeing that, and you need to start sharing that message with others that you're helping coach, because it's true, and you're going to start realizing it with time, that if you can gain 2 pounds in a day because you had a salty miso soup, then you can lose 2 pounds in a day by just drinking more water, having an earlier dinner, and maybe having some more veggies. Okay, so just know you could always lose weight as fast as you can gain it. Questions on pregnancy, breastfeeding, all in the Q&As. And a lot of you are asking like what time you should eat meals. I'm sorry, how's my connection? A lot of people are saying, what time should I eat meals? You have to track it and see. We're all different. Can you guys hear me? Is my connection okay? Okay. So today I want to cover cravings, because you're all talking about cravings. So today the topic that I'm always going to refer to when anyone says, what do I do about cravings? I'm going to say, look at the video, the live video I post in the red top, okay? Because today I want the theme of this video, the mainstay of this video, to be cravings, because I have seen that word come up 100 times. I'm craving this. I'm craving this. What do I do if I'm craving this? So I really want to explain and talk about cravings. So I took some notes that the things I want to cover. The first thing about cravings is your body isn't craving Cheetos. Your mind is craving Cheetos. Okay? So that's one thing. It's like everyone just has to, like, you kind of have to separate your mind from your body, right? Because when you watch the food group videos, you read and you understand that food is purposeful. Water and veggies make us full. Protein keeps us full. High fiber, low sugar, controllable carbs give us good sustained energy. Accessories, healthy fats and sprinkles of this and that to make our meals more delicious so we're full and we're satisfied and we're eating more veggies, all good. The cravings for the other stuff, the silly stuff, extra. Not purposeful, enjoyable, which is fine. We want to be eating for enjoyment, and that's okay. But I want you to really look at the videos, really understand that, like, the best foods are ones that are enjoyable and purposeful. So like the cauliflower rice risotto makes you full, keeps you full, and tastes delicious. That's the best. So the goal is to turn our cravings into things that also serve a purpose. So that's the best way to deal with cravings. That's why Shakeology is great for chocolate cravings or vanilla cravings or peanut butter cravings, by having a vanilla Shakeology with peanut butter powder, right? So, like, you know, you can obviously use Shakeology to do a lot of sweet cravings. A lot of you know my Wonder Whips. It's on my YouTube or on my Instagram, of like whipping Greek yogurt with like cocoa powder and coconut flakes to make an almond joy. I mean, that those Wonder Whips work amazing for curing sweet tooth cravings and experimenting, as does Shakeology as a base. A lot of people are asking me how to make Wonder Whips vegan or dairy-free. I recommend using vegan vanilla Shakeology mixed with not a lot of water and a lot of ice. So you make it thick and then add flavors to that. Or Daiya is a great dairy-free brand that has a high-protein yogurt. Or Kite Hill has a new high-protein dairy-free yogurt, but make sure that you watch the grocery store video and you're not getting a coconut-based yogurt that's really just like higher in fat and doesn't really have any protein in it to keep you full, right? Because like I said, the goal is to have cravings filled by things that serve a purpose and taste good. So they actually keep you full in a way. The beach bars are amazing for like a candy bar craving. So, you know, you use those things. Teas are amazing. My favorite tea is one that I love. It's by this brand called Harney & Sons. It's cinnamon spice tea. I find if I make that with hot water and a splash of almond milk and a little stevia, it tastes like a cinnamon roll. There's like salted caramel teas now. There's vanilla teas. There's like every kind of fruity tea. Teas are your friend. If you're not a tea drinker, I'm no like British like connoisseur of teas. I just figured out a long time ago that they could taste really good, be filling and satisfying, and really curb that sweet tooth, that wanting something while being so high in water, so it actually keeps you full and it keeps your two hands on the wheel. So teas are amazing. So please keep sharing the teas. Water enhancers. I love some water enhancers. So I really try to drink as much water as possible. This bottle makes it so easy, but then there are a lot of all natural water enhancers that are amazing. One is a brand called Stur, S-T-U-R. They have a lot of fruity flavors. Sweet Leaf has one that has a lot of fruity flavors. So I like those all natural water enhancers. One is True Lemon, which I think has no artificial sweeteners. So I like those because I'm drinking tons of water all day, but at night my husband starts eating something silly nearby that's tempting me. I'll make one of those and it solves a sweet tooth. Sparkling waters are great too. Okay, so these are all ways to cure a craving while serving a purpose. Okay, so that's the first thing for a craving. The second thing for a craving, and knowing like my kidneys are not craving chocolate. My mind is craving chocolate. Okay, so separate that. The third thing for cravings is out of sight, out of mind. I'm not joking. Every time I have a private client who tells me they're craving granola, I say, where did you see granola? And they'll be like, I don't know, nowhere. I'm like, you saw it somewhere. They're like, oh, you know what? I was at Costco or I was at the supermarket and they were having little sample cups. In sight, in mind. That's always what happens. Cravings are usually in a response to sight. You're craving chips because your kid is eating it. You're craving pizza because your coworkers are talking about it, right? So like you really have to identify that cravings, one of the best ways to solve them is out of sight, out of mind. And like I said, replace it with something purposeful. So like pizza, I have on my YouTube channel and like a lot of, I talk about it in a lot of the recipes and we'll make more and more recipes hopefully in the future, but like mushroom cap pizzas I love. You can make eggplant pizzas by just roasting slices of eggplant, tomato sauce and cheese. I make egg white pizzas by just making an omelet with tomato sauce and cheese. So again, try to solve the craving and solve a purpose. And that's the best way to do it. So out of sight, out of mind is one of the best ways to like not even have cravings. And when you do have cravings, keep things in sight, in mind, like Shakeology, like the beach bars, like fruity gum or water enhancers or tea that you know can do it, okay? So guacamole, like I have guacamole cravings. I try to get, you know, like they sell lightened up guacamole and I have veggies to snack on it with, so it's gonna fill me up. So really, really, really think about what the cravings are, how you can make it purposeful, and also don't get yourself in a position where you're vulnerable to a craving. So if you want something super silly that doesn't solve a purpose, it's just like a cookie or something that has no protein in it, no fiber in it, okay, it's purely silly, that's okay. But never have that as your first bite. Because that really sets, especially if it's a big open bag, that really sets you up for failure, too vulnerable, you're craving it, you're actually physically hungry, and you have it all in front of you, and it's so tempting, and it's you're just kind of setting yourself up to very easily get out of control of it. If you want something silly, totally fine, but just approach it with the more sure mind. When having water first, filling up on lots of veggies, having some protein, right? Like having scrambled eggs, having some pieces of tofu, having some chicken, you know, like making sure that you're not empty, right? This is something that's curing a craving that's going to taste good, but it's not something that you're depending on to fill up your stomach, okay? And that way you can have one bite to taste. You can eat it slowly and enjoy it and move on without feeling like you need to overindulge, okay? So just, you know, set yourself up for success and go about it smart. I hope my connection is okay. Last thing about cravings is ask yourself with the cravings, is it hunger or is it habit? Hunger or habit? You know, every Sunday, are you craving pancakes? Or like pancakes, we have a great recipe for, but every Sunday, like, are you craving a donut or are you just in the habit of having that every Sunday? You know, like, you have to ask yourself that question, because in the first month, you're gonna make different changes. You're setting new habits. And when you start a new habit, it does feel weird. But when you get past it and you track it and you pat yourself on the back and the scale goes down, it's so much easier the next time you practice that new habit, and it becomes easier and easier and easier. That's why the to-be mindset gets easier with time, because the first time you're faced with like, oh, I'm in the habit of getting that, but I'm in the habit of always getting onion rings, but I'm gonna get a side salad instead. It feels weird, but when you do it and you enjoy it and the scale goes down and you have that positive reinforcement, it makes it a no-brainer to get the salad the next time. So, and it's like you want to, you crave it. So you actually start to change your cravings with the to-be mindset, and you have to be open to that. And you have to also be open to realizing that the first few weeks, the first few opportunities, the first few situations are a learning experience, and go with your gut and choose the better to-be mindset version, because you'll be so happy you did. And you still get the reward because you get to track it later. And you get to say, hey, Sally, right on for making that choice. And then the scale is usually in your favor, and that's another added benefit. So just remember, like, that what do you want now versus what do you want most? And keep telling yourself, every time you're saying I'm craving, say weight loss. If you have weight to lose, and you know that it's in your best interest to lose this weight for your confidence, for your health, for your best well-being and meeting your goals, just always tell yourself, what I'm really craving is feeling good. What I'm really craving is making my life healthier and more vibrant with more energy. And keep reminding yourself what your body is really craving and what you really, really want. And all the other silly cravings tend to work themselves out and seem a lot more insignificant, right? So just keep reminding yourself, like, what I'm really craving is weight loss, and that constant, like, consistent success that feels so good and rewarding, okay? So Shana asked, what are my thoughts on mints? Mints are great. There are a lot of great mints. Okay, and other treats that are purposeful, that are not anything mouth related, doing your nails at night, washing your face, taking a bath, treat yourself to a new book, treat yourself to a self-help podcast, treat yourself to massaging your own hands or asking someone in your family to get your shoulders. There's so many non-ingestible treats and sweets. You know, save up. Every time you save money by not getting that Frappuccino or order of fries, put $2 into a savings account to save up for a new pair of pants when you lose 10 pounds. You know, like, there are so many non-food treats in life that you want to start thinking about. Saudi, one of the coaches who was in the first test group, had such a good tip, which I loved. She said she goes to the supermarket, and at the end, at checkout, she would get herself a little bouquet of flowers. So instead of snacking on all of her groceries when she was undoing her groceries, she would occupy her hands and her thoughts with cutting flowers and putting them in a vase. And that was a treat that lasted a week, let alone you know, something that's like just instant gratification and something that doesn't really do it long term. So think about what treats are rewarding, are fulfilling. Because if you're craving something, that means that you might be craving something more emotional. Like, what are you trying to fill here? Because if it's not purposeful, if it's not going to keep you full and stuff like that, then it's something else. And it might be writing a card. It might be calling a friend. It might be hugging a dog. So just get to the bottom of what that craving is so you can overcome it. Okay? And a lot of times, like I said, out of sight, out of mind. If you're at a Mother's Day brunch on Sunday or at a family meal and you're wanting it, get up, make yourself a tea, go to the bathroom, like, you know, like find a way to feel more in control, because a lot of it is situational when it comes to cravings. Okay, I'm so sorry if my connection isn't good. I feel like it may not be good. I'm working on that. And the last thing I wanted to cover before I take questions is intermittent fasting. I'm getting a lot of questions on intermittent fasting. Is this something you guys want me to answer? I have a lot of questions on this. Okay, so I'm just gonna answer yes. A lot of people are saying yes. So on intermittent fasting, you do not have to fast to lose weight. I'm a big fan of everything I say. I always want to come across as simple, sensible, and sustainable. And fasting is not sustainable. You're going to want to go out to dinner with your family. You're going to want to go to brunch on Sundays with your friends. Like, you got to live your life and you got to have a system that you can sustain and want to sustain. And you definitely don't need to eat within a small window in order to see amazing results. What I will say is that weight loss happens in the absence of glucose and insulin. So you do not have to intermittent fast, but I highly, highly recommend you follow plated dinner and dinner and done. Because if you have a plated dinner that's 25% protein and 75% veggies, and you're dinner and done with like just tea or sparkling water afterwards, you will likely see a weight loss time and time again. And it's actually designed for optimal, what I call fat burning sleep. So you do not have to stop eating at any certain time, but I do want you to look at plate it, because in the world, you get the optimal fat burning hours and you get to eat at sensible normal times. So please, please, please do not think that you need to intermittent fast. In fact, I think that it really messes with people's mindsets, because you give yourself this like artificial cutoff about eating, and I find it makes people feel like they have to like binge like crazy because it's about to be 3 p.m. or whatever. Horrible for your mindset, horrible for your digestion, your metabolism, and likely your weight loss. So please, 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 like just take my best advice on that and really just try to trust the process of the 2B mindset, because the way it's designed is really for optimal fat burn, metabolism, mindset, energy, and everything else. So that's my that is my best recommendation for that. Robin, I really hope you, Robin's saying she's craving cookie dough. Robin, I really hope you listened to the start of this where I was talking about craving. Where is the cookie dough in your life? Is it in sight? Is it in your freezer? Well, then it's probably gonna be in your mind, okay? In sight, in mind, in stomach. Also, is it habit or is it hunger? Is your like pancreas craving cookie dough? I promise you it's not, okay? So it's like, what is it? What's the habit of it, okay? What can we have instead? Vanilla tea, chai with like added vanilla extract and a little stevia, and have it be warm and comforting. Track it, be dinner and done. Go on. You'll start to realize you're just gonna start craving the things that show you progress, because progress is happiness. And you guys are gonna realize that with time, you will start craving the things that are contributing to you feeling so good in your body today, tomorrow, and every day. Because the best thing to crave is a smaller clothing size, or compliments from friends, or better energy, or more comfort, or less back pain, or better digestion, and all these things that can come with the benefits of eating well day to day. So I really, really, really recommend reevaluating what you're saying you're craving and really get to the bottom of what it is you're trying to fill. Okay, so now I'm going to answer questions. So today I covered how to best have a great group dynamic. I covered what's already been covered, what questions have been covered, and where to find answers, which is likely as you keep watching the videos, reading the materials, reading the Q&As, and reading previous comments. I hope you hear me. Cravings, everything about cravings, and my opinion on intermittent fasting. Okay, so now let me take extra questions. Someone is asking about 12-hour shifts. This question has come up many times. My best recommendation for 12-hour shifts is to track it and see, write the timing of your meals in your tracker, learning what's best for you, and finding your own system. I can't tell anyone when to have breakfast, lunch, and dinner. All of our days are different. There's not two people in this group who have the same schedule, same living situation, same cravings, same stresses, same anything. So we all need to just track and see and trust the process and be open to either losing weight or learning from it. And that way you'll figure out your best system without having me needing to prescribe anything to you. And that's what's so healing and sustainable about this program. So, Christy's asking about hypoglycemia. If you have gastric sleeve or diabetes or are pregnant or have any sort of medical condition, you need to consult with your doctor if you have any big questions. You need to modify the program according to your best health and needs. And you need to prioritize your best health care. So if you are diabetic and you're seeing low blood sugars, you need to modify and adjust and make sure that your health is of the utmost priority and make sure that you are safe and healthy. Miranda asked about recover post-workout. I recommend reading the Q&As, watching the video in the success group guide with Lara and Denise talking about the workout programs and the recover. And again, track and see. Veronica asked, okay, I'm gonna take this last question. Veronica asked, I was so used to eating 7 times a day, now I'm not used to eating 3 times a day. I really recommend going to the live video I posted the first day. I'm wearing a black thing and I spoke about why I like 3 meals versus snacking all day. Better, in my opinion, for fat burn, weight loss, and mindset. Just being able to eat, be satisfied, move on with your day rather than think that you need to be eating all the time, respecting your own hunger, going into a meal hungry, feeling full and satisfied, having your thing, and being able to move on. Amazing for your mindset and very, very excellent for weight loss as well. So please watch the video where I'm wearing a black top to go into that further. What other questions? I'm sorry that my connection's breaking up. So I'm going to stop because I'm sorry my connection's bad. My hardwire is coming in for internet connectivity. I love you guys so much. Veronica, I recommend the More Sure model and the More Sure model and the More Sure model and just track it and see. That's really the best answer for almost every question. I love you guys. Oh, Liz, I'm gonna answer this last question. Liz Gottschall, great, great question. Liz Gottschall asked, how do you stop snacking while cooking? Liz, this was one of my biggest struggles because I'm such a picker. So hard to not snack while cooking. That's why I love water bottle nearby. I actually like cooking things you cannot taste while making, like my meatballs, like you'll get sick. Don't touch that. So I find that to be helpful. Also, I have gum in my kitchen. That's where I keep gum. I find if I'm making something that doesn't have eggs in it or something and it's easy to taste, I'll pop mint gum in my mouth. If I'm cooking for like lots of people, I have family coming over, I'm such a bad picker that I know that I won't put salmon in my mouth if I have mint gum in my mouth. So one of my best tips for not picking while eating is that. That really works for me. Because I'm such a picker. And it really helps. I love you guys so much. And I'm gonna go because I feel like the connectivity is not good, but I'm gonna work on that. I love you.